It's Christmas vacation 2011. I'm at Los Angeles International Airport, LAX. My husband, my daughter, my friend Gary, and his family were all traveling to Manzanillo, Mexico. Seven of us going. I haven't heard much about Manzanillo, but I do know that I'd seen a movie with Dudley Moore called 10. And I thought maybe if I had my hair braided, I could look like Bo Derek. In the meantime, I was not very happy about being at LAX. There's two airports that I avoid at all costs, LAX and JFK. But Gary's made the arrangements. He's got us his house reserved, and he told me there are no flights from San Francisco, SFO, directly to Manzanillo, so we need to go through LAX. So I'm walking through the airport, and we not only have to change planes, we have to change concourses, and our flight isn't even on United, it's on Mexicana. So if any of you have ever traveled on Mexicana, it's not a sure thing. It's not a sure thing we're gonna get there. But we get to the gate, and there's nobody there. It's really early in the morning, it's about 7:30 in the morning. And so we say, well, the flight's not till 9:00. Let's go have breakfast. On the way to go get breakfast, I started feeling like I'm really excited about my friends and my family and chilling in Mexico, but I'm looking for something more fulfilling than just a hangout vacation. Well, we get back to the ticket counter and the gate, and there's the flight. Oh, finally, the travel agent's there. They're the ticketing agent. And Gary says, here we are, seven of us for Manzanillo, Mexico. Well, I'm sorry, sir, but there are only 6 seats left. What do you mean? 7 of us, and we've got these reservations confirmed. Sorry, sir, you got here too late. Well, where were you when we came before? Well, this went back and forth, and finally, I just said, I volunteer. I'll catch up with you later. I've done it many times on flights where get bumped, and then you catch the next flight. Well, I didn't take into consideration that it's 2 days before Christmas, and this flight to Manzanillo goes twice a week. Oh, no, what am I gonna do? I'm gonna get on the phone and start calling all the airlines, and I reach in to my backpack, and I take out my phone. Oh, God, I only have 50% phone. I better be careful. Where's my charger? My charger's on my check bag on its way to Manzanillo. So I decide I need to go from ticket counter, I need to go to Delta, I need to go to American and try and get myself to Manzanillo. No luck, no luck, no luck. Finally, this Delta agent sees me and has heard my story and said, I can help you, dearie, come on over here. So let's see, you wanna get to Manzanillo? Okay, well let me let you know, Delta does not fly directly from LAX to Manzanillo, but we'll get you to Mexico City. Oh, okay, let's see now. Okay, and you need to go through Denver. Denver? I'm going to Denver, I'm trying to get, it doesn't make any sense. I'm sorry, dear, but let's at least get you that flight. You'll get in around midnight. Okay, Ginger Park. Oh dear, I've got some bad news for you. What's going on? That flight's been canceled. Oh no, what's the lesson in this? The flight crew stuck in Detroit, bad weather back east. Let me see, well here, I can see you're so upset. So for sure, I'm gonna give you a voucher for a room at the Holiday Inn because it's only 9 in the morning and the flights aren't gonna go till late tonight. And then I'm gonna give you a voucher for taxi and I'm gonna give you a voucher for food. But let's get you there. Okay, I finally found a flight for you. All right, dear. Okay, here you go. You're gonna leave at 11:50 tonight on a red eye. To Mexico City? No, JFK. WTF. What the, am I going to JFK to, oh. I'm sorry, dear, that's all I can do. And you'll make the changes and you'll fly through to Mexico City after you get off the plane JFK tomorrow morning. And then you'll get to Manzanillo. Okay, okay. So I leave the airport pretty downhearted, and I take a taxi to the Holiday Inn. And they give me a room, and I guess they made arrangements for us to go, for me to be able to go early in the morning, and I collapse. We've been there. We've been at the airport, and I've been up since 3 in the morning, because, you know, international flights, you have to check in early. And I'm really tired, and I lay down in these clean sheets, and I... Oh, no. What if I get stuck in New York? These are the only clothes I have. And I start looking through my backpack. What do I have? A bathing suit. My husband says you always have to travel to Mexico with a bathing suit just in case they lose your backpack. So just in case. And I have a pair of panties just in case. And I have a notebook and a book and my trusty, really beat up Spanish-American dictionary. And I need this and I love this. So what am I going to do? I've got no clothes. What if I get some? I'm going to call my friends, Jerry and Vita. They don't live far from here. What do you mean to tell me, honey? Darling, you got to be at LAX airport till midnight? Come on over here. We'll take care of you. And they do. Jerry and Vita, she and I are about the same size, except for shoes. So she gives me some leggings, and she gives me a sweater, and I stuff everything in my backpack, and then she gives me a size 7 shoe. Now, I have on sandals, and I'm a size 5. But so she gives me several pairs of socks. I said, listen, something's better than freezing. And they give me a charger, and then they decide to get me stoned before I go back to the airport. You know that feeling when your psyche kind of shifts and all of a sudden something's looking really nice that wasn't so nice before? So I'm feeling no pain. I've got my charger, I've got clothes, I've got a ticket, and I get back to the airport. Now, LAX has really filled up then. People are pushing, but yeah, people are absolutely nutso. It's December 23rd. They're trying to get to their places. There's one man at the counter. He's complaining that his dog has definitely got a ticket. Didn't they see he had his ticket? And then this other woman, I mean, the nerve of people. She's got a broken arm, but she's got 3 bags and she wants help. Me, I'm just feeling no pain. Oh, look at them. I know I've got a seat on the plane and I know I'm going to go to JFK. Anyway. I'm trying to learn the lesson in this. So I get up to the counter and he says, oh, your ticket's been flagged, miss. No, what's the matter? He says, no, we're gonna escort you to your flight because the security line is really long. And I hadn't noticed it at that point. I said, oh God, thank goodness. And he takes me through and I'm at the front of the line and I get to my gate.
Boarding flight 309 to JFK. All boarding now. Will Ginger Parnes please come to the gate, agent?
What's going on now? First class? I look out over that Delta agent and she winks at me. Well, this is pretty good, you know? And I'm telling you, I've just seen the insanity of humanity. And now I've seen the kindness of strangers, as they say. And where do I fit in? I'll tell you where I fit in. Seat 3A in first class. And I settle into this seat and it's big and leather. And I put the legs up and I'm just sitting there. This is really a little stone too. And champagne, yes. And I fall asleep. Next thing I know,
we are now approaching JFK. We'll be letting you off on gate D9. Welcome to New York City.
So I flew it all night. I'm really tired. I go clean myself up. It's 6:30 a.m. The flight's not till 9, but I go and I look at my ticket. Gate D9. I'm getting right back on that same plane I just got off of. This is so, what is the lesson in this? Anyway, not first class. But eventually, I'm at least heading west again. We land in Mexico City. I've never been there, but the airport, oh no, I have a new airport to add to my list. Jostling and people with the Christmas presents and the trunks and all these things and bustling and bustling. Should I take a taxi and have a tour? I've got 4 hours. Take a tour of Mexico City? No, I need something really to quiet me down. I'm gonna go find a cafe or a place to have lunch. I see a sign that says cafe, and then there's a Spanish word that I don't understand, but I go and start to go up to where that cafe is. And as I'm climbing the stairs to go up to the cafe, I see tools and dust and, oh no, the cafe is under construction. There's nobody there. I can't see him. Oh, I see a little boy. Hola, hola, hola. ¿Qué pasa? Restaurante de mi tío. Oh, it's your uncle's restaurant. How? What's your name? Julio. Oh, nice to meet you, Julio. ¿Habla inglés? Do you speak in English? No, no. Estudio poco en la escuela. Well, today is your lucky day because I'm an English teacher. Come on, Julio. And I take him over and we dust off one of these banquettes and I sit him down next to me and I take out my notebook and a pen and my dictionary and I spend the next who knows how long talking to Julio in Spanish and English. And I teach him words. I teach him how to use the dictionary. He had never had a dictionary before. And I look up Spanish words. He looks up English. It was wonderful. It was so fulfilling. And I, all of a sudden, I hear my flight's being called. Julio. Julio, honey, my airplane's leaving soon. I have to go. Oh, no, senora. And I see this little tear coming down his beautiful eyes. Yeah, Julio. And I make a quick decision. Julio, I have a gift for you. Un regalo. Here's my Spanish-English dictionary. Oh, senora, gracias, gracias, senora. And I leave kind of teary myself, and as I go down and head off to the gate, I look back up, and Julio's waving goodbye to me. And after 5 flights and 5,761 miles, I want to ask you, who do you think really had the lesson that day? Thank you.